The implication here is, of course, we're going to have to take that leap of faith to reach the new land. Going on, he said, many years ago, one of the leading contributors to this book came under our care in this hospital. He's talking about Bill now. And while here, he acquired some ideas which he put into practical application at once. The ideas we've already discussed. We looked at them on page 13, didn't we? And then on page 14, putting them into practical use at once, a big part of that had to be with carrying the message to others. Later, he requested the privilege of being allowed to tell his story to other patients here, and with some misgiving, we consented. The cases we have followed through have been most interesting. In fact, many of them are amazing. The unselfishness of these men as we've come to know them, the entire absence of profit motive, and their community spirit is indeed inspiring to one who has labored long and wearily in this alcoholic field. They believe in themselves, and still more in the power which pulls chronic alcoholics back from the gates of death. Notice that Dr. Silkworth capitalized the word power, which indicates that he's talking about deity. Not talking about doorknobs or ashtrays or pickup trucks. Talking about a deity. They believe in themselves and still more in the power which pulls chronic alcoholics back from the gates of death. Not because somebody convinced us that we should go out and proselytize with these theories or this philosophy, but because when we go out to do this work, we're talking about what happened to us. And we know it's true because it worked for us. That's the most powerful message you can carry. Of course, an alcoholic ought to be freed from his physical craving for liquor, and this often requires a definite hospital procedure before psychological measures can be of maximum benefit. I suppose that that's the only way that he could adequately express it based upon his own experience and his own practice and his own expertise and his own studies. But you and I don't apply psychological measures. There isn't anything psychological about the 12 steps. They are spiritual in every aspect. Just remind ourselves, in the big book on page 30, it says we learned that we had to fully concede to our innermost selves that we were alcoholics. This is the first step to recovery. And then it says the delusion that we're like other people or presently may be has to be smashed. In other words, the idea that somehow someday we can drink again like normal people has to be smashed. Let's see what Doctor says about that. We believe, and so suggested a few years ago, that the action of alcohol in these chronic alcoholics is a manifestation of an allergy. Now there's the crux of the doctor's opinion in terms of its physical impact, the manifestation of an allergy, that the phenomenon of craving is limited to this class and never occurs in the average temperate drinker. In other words, the doctor said the alcoholic is set aside, is different and apart from the general population. On a physical basis now. On a physical basis. Now here's the rule. These allergic types can never safely use alcohol in any form at all. That's pure first step. You see, when we get to the first step, it is absolutely essential and critical that we accept as a fact that we can never drink again, that the plug is in the jug for good and all. These allergic types can never safely use alcohol in any form at all, and once having formed the habit and found they cannot break it, once having lost their self-confidence, their reliance upon things human, Their problems pile up on them and become astonishingly difficult to solve.